Hi, thanks for clicking on the video. You know, sometimes in financial model, I come across a situation where I need to do a projection of values between two data points. As the values can take many different paths to reach the end point, I create a functionality that lets the user to easily play with the path. In this video, you would learn how to do that. But before I explain that, let us first understand why we should do that. I am taking the illustration of Noida Toll Bridge Authority, which was a toll road operator in India. Let us say you were given the average traffic per day between 2001 and 2007. Let us say it was expected to be 17,000 in 2001 and 68,652 in 2007. Now this works out to a CAGR of 26%. If an analyst were to use this CAGR to project the annual traffic data, this is what we would have got. Now let us look at the actuals. These were numbers I collected from news articles. Let me plot them in a chart and compare them side by side. As you can see, although the values at the beginning and end were same, the CAGR based projection would have given much lower for most part of the time period. The CAGR projection is concave upwards, whereas the actual data follows a logistic curve. We also call it as the S curve because if you tilt the data, it would look somewhat like an S. We cannot form an S curve with just two data points, but I can frame a logarithmic curve. Here I have my logarithmic projection. When I add that to the chart, you notice that it is a much closer fit than the exponential curve we initially had. This is why we need to learn to do forecast through approaches other than just CAGR. And here I'm going to show you how to do it with logarithm. Before we get started with that, let us understand some basics. If you have a series x that's growing by a constant amount such that it has a linear growth path, then the log of the series would essentially follow a convex path. Now, with that, let's come to our illustration. I'm using tables and dynamic arrays to do the illustration, but you can also do it the older way. In case if you want to exactly follow the steps and you do not have Office 365, then you can try the Office Online, which is available for free. So here we have been given the traffic estimate for 2020 and that is 1000, and the estimate for 2030 is 5000. If this data has to follow logarithmic path, then anti-log. In other words, the exponential should follow a linear path. So that is what we need to do first. To get exponential, first we need to identify the base of the log. For now, let me take it as 2. We'll come to this number a little later. Now let us proceed to get the exponentials. But there is a problem in taking exponentials of these values. You can see that when I try to calculate the exponential, I get an error, and that is because the value is too huge. 2 to the power 5000 is a very big number. So what do we do? We have to reduce the magnitude of the problem. Since 1000 is our lowest value, I am going to take our lowest value as 1 and I am going to divide all the values by 1000. So 1000 becomes 1 and 5000 becomes 5. I can now take the base of log to the power 1 and base of log to the power 5. If these values were to follow a straight line, then I need to first obtain the slope, which is just the difference between the number divided by the number of years. Since I'm using tables and arrays, we are going to follow a fail-proof approach, which may look slightly lengthy. So first I'm going to get the number of rows. This is actually not very important. Then let's get to the start year. Now start year is going to be the smallest year in the year column, and let's get the end year, which is going to be the largest value in the year column. I am using the min and max function instead of directly linking, so that if someone were to sort our table, we would still get the right values. Now let's get the gap between the two now, that's 10 years. And if we included 2020, we would have one more year in our forecast. So we would have 10 plus 1, 11 years. Now let us calculate the slope that is going to be applicable. That is going to be applicable exponential value for last year minus applicable exponential or anti-log value for the first year and divided by the gap. That is first 30, then divided by 10, which is equal to 3. I was using the XLOOKUP function to get this mainly to ensure that we get the right data in all circumstances. But mathematically, it is just 32 minus 2, the whole divided by 10. Now let us do the rest of the work. Let us set up the year. I'm going to generate this using the sequence function. So sequence, Open the bracket. We need 11 rows of data and one column. The data should start at 2020. Let's specify that. Now we have the years. If you do not have dynamic array feature, you can also get them using simply copy pasting. Now we need to do linear interpolation of anti-log for each of these years. Even though it's not very critical, I'm going to create a serial number column just for some help. Here I'm going to create a serial number starting from 0. We know that if the anti-log has to have linear growth, then it should increase by the value of the slope every year. So we can here give the formula as the base of the log plus slope times the serial number range. Because the serial number array is dynamic, I'm going to add a hash sign next to it. Now we've got the anti-log moving in straight line. Keep in mind, we wanted to get this so that we can take log of these values. So let us take the log. Log of the anti-log array to the base. Now we've got these values. But keep in mind, these values that we have got are not the traffic per se, but the traffic index. We earlier divided all the values by the lowest value in our list to reduce the magnitude. So now let us multiply it with that lowest value in order to restore the original numbers. That is it. We've got this. When I plot it in a chart now, you do see that it follows a logarithmic curve. And now let me touch upon the base of the log. How do we determine what should be the base? But before that, first let's understand the role of the base. If the base is very high, we would see that there would be a steep rise in the initial years. And if the base is low, the growth would be more gradual. If the base is below 1, it would in fact look like an exponential curve. So if we only have the start and end data, the base will depend on our judgment. We can choose the base based on what shape we think the curve would look like. But if we have one more data for an intermediate point, then we can fit the curve properly using trial and error. So let's assume that we've been told that the traffic would reach 4000 by 2025. Now we can use goal seek to get the base. Go to data, what if analysis, goal seek. We want 2025 value to be 4000. So I'm going to set that cell to value 4000 by changing the base. So now click OK. Excel runs the trial and error iterations. Now we've got a base that runs through all the three data points. That's it. I hope you found this video useful. Now, depending upon various circumstances and the data points, you can use various approaches to interpolate or extrapolate various data paths. Perhaps we'll discuss that sometime in future. I hope you like this video. Now, just to sound like a news media, so remember, if you see this technique sometime in the future, you saw it here first. See you next time, and until then, take care.